Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Nuggets News. In tonight's video, I've got a special guest, and that's Daniel, the founder and CEO of Living Room of Satoshi, which I've mentioned a few times recently. So welcome, Daniel.
Thanks, Alex. It's good to be on the show.
No worries. So for those that don't know, Living Room of Satoshi is an Australian website that lets you pay bills and bank deposits with cryptocurrency. So do you want to give us a brief history of yourself, Daniel, and how you got into crypto?
Yeah, so I've been a computer programmer for a long time. Worked at banks and with MasterCard and even at the ATO, the tax office, for a little while. And so the technical side of Bitcoin fascinated me. When that white paper was released, it was easy to read and just mind-blowing that finally someone had cracked digital money. You know, you can send money directly from one person to another. So I had to get some of it and try it out. I wired some money over to Mt. Gox in Japan, that infamous exchange that some of your viewers probably still have money stuck at.
Yes.
And I got my first Bitcoin that way.
No worries. So do you want to give us a little bit of the history of the Living Room of Satoshi, how long it's been around? And I believe you guys won Best Startup Business in Australia in 2015.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, we've been recognised there. We came runner-up this year in the FinTech Awards too. Hopefully we'll win it next year, but we'll see. But yeah, for about 3 years, we've been allowing people to pay their BPAY bills with Bitcoin directly. So your Telstra bill, for example, you can, instead of paying it with Australian dollars, you go to Living Room of Satoshi and you can pay it with Bitcoin. And as well as that, we've added the option to pay with your bank, to two bank accounts. So there's about 45,000 billers accepting BPAY, but for everyone else, like maybe your tradie or your dentist or something, or your accountant, you can pay them with Bitcoin through our website as well.
Yeah, and so I've got that screen up now, so I'm showing the viewers as we speak. And just to be clear, that isn't an opt-in process. Any a business that has a BPAY facility, you can pay with your cryptocurrency.
Yeah, that's right. And we publish a bunch of stats about what kind of bills people are paying to on the stats page. It's very interesting. All sorts of things people pay, even their tax bill.
Yep, I'll just bring that up now for viewers to have a look at. But I guess, how's the adoption been and how have you seen the growth since you started the business a few years back?
Yeah, adoption's been massive. I mean, it was, especially this year, I think it's there's been a lot less stigma attached with Bitcoin. It's becoming a bit more accepted. So we've got over 1,000 regular repeat users now of our service, and we've done about $10 million in bill payments, and yeah, it's just growing.
That's great to see. And I know just our Crypto Australia Facebook page and my YouTube channel, I mean, we're just growing exponentially as more people are getting into this space. And I joke about how the correlation between new users and the price going up seems to be pretty high, but hopefully it's a trend that we see continue, as I know people do, I guess they are saving money and there are plenty of benefits to using cryptocurrency rather than other methods, if you want to touch on that a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I mean, it's a way to, you know, I've run businesses in the past and there's a lot of friction having that third party involved. You know, there's a lot of trouble with PayPal sometimes, just organizing those accounts. But this is a new way where there's really no third party, and it's really going to revolutionize things.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm just going to open up the drop-down menu, and we've got 8 different cryptocurrencies you guys are accepting at the moment, or 9 there, sorry, now with Bitcoin Cash as well. Any plans to implement more in the future? Or?
Yeah, we do have further plans to add them. It's mostly based on customer demand, so if there's something that you think you'd use, yeah, let us know.
Absolutely. And I guess another thing just to touch on while I've got that menu up is there's no sign up if you don't want to on Living Room of Satoshi. You can do all this anonymously. And there is the privacy-based coins if you want even another layer again, in those Dash, Monero, and PIVX, the really privacy-based coins. But, yeah, no need to sign up. That's right, or?
Yeah, exactly. So in the same spirit of Bitcoin, I guess, we don't want to collect any information about our customers that we don't need. It's safer for your data, and it's safer for us as well.
Yeah, so for viewers, that means that you just have to deposit the cryptocurrency to the address and then enter the BSB, an account number, or the biller code if you're doing a BPAY bill, and that'll do the rest for you. So nice and easy. And There is the option to sign up and earn rewards points, though, if you want to touch on that.
Yeah, that's right. We started a rewards program just to give you a little bit of reward for every single bill you pay, even your everyday bills. And we find a lot of people are cashing in those rewards points for things like hardware wallets. You can see a giant list of things on the rewards page, but a lot of Trezors and Ledgers being claimed, which are really essential, I think, for anyone involved in crypto these days.
And I might just touch on that now. I know not a lot of places are sold out, but you've told me in the pre-interview that you guys do have plenty of Ledgers and Trezors left, so I'm sure you'll see a wave of customers just for that.
We ordered a whole heap, so if you don't have one yet, make sure you claim one.
That's great. So you touched on that you had worked at the ATO in the past, and for my viewers, I have done a taxation video about how it works in Australia, and for personal expenditure under $10,000, you don't have to pay capital gains, basically, and that's my understanding. So would your views be in line with that?
Yeah, we have the same understanding as well. The ATO has a page published where they explain things in a bit more detail, which is definitely worth reading about, which you already informed your viewers about. But if you're concerned about cashing out larger amounts of Bitcoin, it does depend a bit on your personal circumstances, so speak to your accountant.
Absolutely, yep. So I guess where do you see this going in the future, mate? Hoping to grow into other branches, or are you just hoping to grow the user base?
Yeah, we want to start taking some of BPay's market share. They're sort of a monopoly bill payment service that's owned by the big four. A lot of people don't know that. And give merchants another option, you know, besides BPay, which they have to be locked into. And eventually, I guess, just start bringing on board some of these retailers and show them how to use Bitcoin. Maybe get them to cash out, you know, keep half the Bitcoin and half in Australian dollars. I noticed that Overstock, a large retailer overseas, is doing that now. It's a good way to introduce merchants to the idea of accepting Bitcoin with the ultimate goal of accepting it directly.
Absolutely, and the more people we get into this, the better it is for everyone, I guess. So for my viewers, I will put a link to the Living Room of Satoshi website. Please use that link. It's in the description of all my videos, as I love supporting Australian businesses and anything that grows cryptocurrency. So anything else you wanted to say, Daniel, before we wrap up?
Yeah, I guess if you run a business or you're some sort of retailer and you don't know how to get started, send us an email because we want to help.
Absolutely. Well, thanks a lot for coming on, mate. I'll just stop the recording process, but that's all been great.
Thanks, Alex.